Rebecca is with us. Hi, Rebecca. How are you?
Hi, I'm doing great. Thank you so much for taking my call.
Sure. What's up?
All right. Are you sitting down? This is a big one, Dave.
Okay.
So my husband is a dentist. I'm a nurse practitioner. Our annual income is about $330,000 a year. In 2020, I opened up my own practice with zero debt because I'm extremely debt averse. I drink the Kool-Aid, although I'm not good at following through. I wish I was better. But we'll get there. So obviously, starting out the practice, didn't have a lot of income with that, so we really were relying on my husband's income. But now I'm starting to bring in an income for our family. So our house payment is $2,800 a month. We have over $500,000 in student loans. We have no other debt. We've already paid off over just $100,000, but it has taken us 4 years to get to this point. We were hoping that by 4 to 5 years after my husband graduated, we'd have it all paid off. But like I said, we're not so great with the follow through. So here's the deal. My husband's
Stop me just a second. Let me ask you one clarifying question.
Okay.
Your practice is now taken off. What does your husband make?
So my husband makes, we were looking back.
Now, what will he make this year? What will he make in a year this year?
What are you going to make this year? 330 is what we're thinking.
Okay. And what are you going to make now that the practice is moving?
Well, I'm hoping right now I've been bringing home consistently for about the last 3 months between $2,000 to $5,000, depending on, I just go off of a percentage of my.
What do you think you're going to make in the year?
What do I think? I'm going to make $100,000.
I think you are. And then the next year, you're going to make $150,000.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah. Okay. That's realistic. Okay. So you have a $430,000 income in 2022.
Yes. Okay.
You've never had that before.
Never.
So we don't need to throw you under the bus so much for not following through in the past. Maybe a little, but not so much.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, you never really had an income above 200, but much before this year, right?
No. Okay. Never. No.
So your income's legitimately doubled this year.
Legitimate, yes.
Yeah. Okay, good. You guys are.
Are you ready?
The good news is you have a really big shovel while you have a really big hole.
But here's the kicker, Dave. I need this advice because my husband and I are on different aspects of this. So he wants to buy into his practice. And
no,
we're only gonna buy
you're broke people. You don't buy into practice when you're broke people.
Okay, thank you.
Absolutely not. It's unwise.
I know.
It's not just a Dave Ramsey thing.
I agree.
It's financially unwise. Yeah. You can't walk around with your head in the clouds acting like you have $500,000 in student loan debt, acting like you don't have any debt.
I know.
This is a dentist disease. I swear to God, of all the doctors I work with, dentists go into more debt than all of them put together. They go for, because for some reason, a dental degree is more. I don't even understand that.
It is.
But I mean, I meet a lot of dentists that are 300 to 400 in student loan debt, and then they want to go another 300 to 500 in and buy into a practice or build a practice from scratch and go buy all the equipment, one of the two, and try to do it all at the same time, and walk around acting like, where do they teach you in dental school that $1 million is a great thing to be in debt amount? No, 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 no. You've got time, but you need to lay a foundation. You're going to be very, very wealthy if you do this right, or you're going to be walking around with debt hanging around your neck with a level of stress that you can't even breathe for the next decade because you just won't say no to yourself.
Right. That's how I feel.
Yeah. I mean, you can tell. There's two types of dentists out there when it comes to our material. Ones that love me and ones that hate me. There is no middle ground.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because the typical model is what your husband's laying out. He's going right down the dental school template. All of his buddies are doing the same stupid butt stuff he's trying to do.
He's pointing out to me right now that he wants me to share with you that his income's going to increase to $502,000, the loan payment's $146,000, he'll make $357,000 a year, and that's an extra $37,000 a year that he'll be bringing home after he buys into the practice.
Yeah, if he doesn't get sick or there's not a pandemic or one of the partners doesn't commit a crime and blow the whole thing up.
Right. I know. Yeah,
see,
I know.
The only way his crap works is if everything works. And you know when everything works in this world? Never.
Never.
It's a freaking optimistic. I appreciate optimism, but that amount of debt is beyond optimism. It's fantasy land.
Okay.
So he can buy into the practice later, or he can buy into another practice. One thing about dentists is there's always one for sale.
Mm-hmm.
You can always get another one. It's like financial planners with a book of business. You can always get a book of business. They're out there. And if he can't buy into this practice, he can buy into another one later. Please don't do this. Please, 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 okay. please, 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 please. Listen, here's the thing. The reason I'm saying all this is not just because of dad or something like that. The reason, the bottom line reason this whole thing is, I truly believe after 30 years of doing this, and obviously coaching a whole bunch of dentists in the process, that 10 years from today, you will be wealthier following what I'm telling you to do than following what he's talking about. Okay. I really do believe that because I don't think he's factoring in any kind of risk in his equations. And right. The only way his stuff works is if it works perfectly, and it never works perfectly. I mean, you've got crazy people in Washington, D.C. You've got crazy people in the medical community. Oh, sorry. You got crazy people in, you know, I mean, out here with the COVID stuff. And, you know, you just don't know what suddenly we're just going to change the way business is done in America. Why? We just decided to. No, this scares the crud out of me.
Me too.
I'm so thankful you were not. Think about it. Think about if you were in this and how much dentistry went on during COVID.
None for 3 months. We know.
Yeah. And, you know, what would have happened? Oh, my God. Y'all are acting like you didn't just come through that.
I'm just wondering, can this be like a 3 to 5 year goal?
Yeah, I mean, like, well, here's the thing. You ought to be debt-free in 2 years.
Right, because I'm like a $430,000 income. You guys could live on $100,000 and still have $330,000
to put towards your debt.
Yeah,
you got taxes out of that. But, I mean, come on. Yeah. Lower your freaking lifestyle. Stay home.
Yep.
And work and knock this debt out in 2 years. You should be debt free and then save up and pay cash. I don't want to hear about a loan for buying into the practice. Just pay cash to buy into the practice.
Okay.
That could happen in 5 years. That's not a very long trajectory.
And if these guys don't want to wait and they think you've lost your mind, then you probably have the wrong partners anyway, because they're all going to be in debt up to their eyeballs and run the thing into the dirt. So, dentistry is, it's as unpredictable as any other business or industry right now. So, no, please don't do that. I'm afraid I can't talk him out of it. But she was already talked out of it before she called. She's weaponizing the Ramsey Show. But it's all right. It's all right. We have to be good for something around here. Weapons we can do.
Hey, I think they can get there. Give yourself some time, though.
Save
up.
$250,000 a year in debt reduction. I mean, who can do that? You can do that. Nobody else can do that. And you could be done in 2 freaking years. First world problems. This is the Ramsey Show.